Christ, we can be resurrected to God through his blood, through his death, through his resurrection, that we can be right with Jesus Christ. If we are willing to repent and accept him in our hearts, if we are willing to repent and accept him in our life today, and let Jesus Christ rule in your life, let Jesus Christ rule in your heart, because the fact is, somebody is going to rule you. Either it's going to be Jesus Christ or it's going to be Lucifer. But you're obeying somebody right now in your mind. When the devil tells you to keep walking through this, you have to obey yourself. The devil is tempting you for your soul. The devil says, go drink that beer, and you say, yes, daddy. The devil says, go hate that person, and you say, yes, daddy. The devil tells you to smoke that, you say, yes, daddy. The devil tells you to pull that machine, and you say, yes, daddy. The devil is tempting you for your soul, but Jesus Christ wants to set you back. You don't have to be bound by sin. You don't have to be bound and on your way to hell. All the devil doing is using trickery to trick your mind, to deceive you, to give you a temporal pleasure so that you can receive eternal punishment in the end. But Jesus Christ came to set you free from that because he loves you so much. He became man. He took upon himself all sins. He took upon himself the punishment that we deserve. Jesus Christ, God in the flesh, who did no wrong, who committed no sin. He took judgment upon himself because he loved us so much that he chose to have himself tormented and destroyed so that we could live. And he went to hell and took the keys of death, and he overcame hell, he overcame death, he overcame the destruction. Jesus Christ is the only way for salvation. Jesus Christ will set you free from sin. You don't have to be out here trying to knock a prostitute to give you money. You don't have to be out here trying to pull a slot machine to give you money. You don't have to be out here trying to sell some dope to give you money, to sell some thin steels, whatever you guys are doing today, the mollies. All you have to do is give your life to Jesus Christ, and he will set you free from your sins. Jesus Christ will set you free. You can be born again. You can be given a new life. You can be given a new heart. We can actually serve the Lord our God with our heart, our soul, our mind, and our strength. Holy Ghost, be given the power. Holy Ghost, be given the desires of our hearts. Jesus Christ our Savior, us to desire, and then we become with him. We become a person that has the mind of Christ. We can be changed right now if we are willing to accept Jesus Christ, if we are willing to turn from our sins, if we stop allowing the devil to pinpoint for our souls, if we stop allowing the devil to tempt us, if we stop allowing the sin to tempt us, then you have to get their body. If you would stop allowing the dope man to put dope inside your body, people walking around with a guard with a key falling off, it's a skin peeling off, people are prostituting. Jesus Christ wants to give you life. He wants to set you free from those things. He wants to heal you. He wants to set you free from the destruction and the death. Jesus Christ is the life giver. He wants to give you eternal life because he loves you. Jesus Christ will help you serve him. He would give you the Holy Spirit. He said, I would not allow you to be comfortless. I would give you the Holy Spirit, and he will remind you of all the things I have taught you. He will fill your heart with the Spirit of God. He would give you a boldness. Forgiving them as they were killing him. You don't know that kind of love. You don't know that revengeless love. You don't know that selfless love. But you can know it only through Jesus Christ. That is that activity of the complete life. We can live an abundant life. We can live the life of Jesus Christ. We can live the resurrection life. We simply live a life right now. Everything we're doing right now is Israel. Your life is amazing. It's like a cup of smoke in God's eyes. And Christ, God's being God. God's being God. Out of heaven, that don't impress him at all. What impresses him is the life that will break down and change. You know, the first thing is Christ, kick the devil in the teeth and take your life back. That's how you impress Jesus. You're not impressing your life right now by allowing the devil to pimp you for your soul, allowing the devil to cast you in shackles and slavery. All you do is show him what kind of person you are. You are a person that is bowing down to sin, bowing down to Satan, allowing yourself to be in slavery, allowing yourself to be tempted, and you can be set free. If you're walking down freedom, you're doing the death and destruction. You complain about the things that are going on in the world, but you want to do nothing about it because you want to accept Jesus Christ. If the people in the world were saying you wouldn't think about the things going on in the world. People are killing people because they're not saved. They don't have Jesus Christ in their hearts. People are doing the things they're doing because they don't have Jesus Christ in their heart. People are getting robbed because they don't have Jesus Christ in their heart. If people had Christ in their heart, they wouldn't be out robbing nobody. They wouldn't be out gangbanging and killing nobody. They wouldn't be out selling dope. They wouldn't be out pimping. The destruction you see in our country is because of sin. The destruction you see in our country is because of the lack of Jesus Christ. All the things that are keeping us down, all the things that are keeping us behind bars, is all pointing to sin. Sin is destruction. Sin will always keep you empty. Sin will keep you people in prison.
But we want to accept him into our hearts. Today is the day for salvation, friend. Jesus Christ has risen from the dead. Would you be born again? Would you accept Jesus Christ into your heart today? Would you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Jesus Christ is the only way to heaven. Jesus Christ is the only salvation. Jesus Christ is the only hope. Jesus Christ is the resurrection and the life. Jesus Christ is setting you free from the bonds of sin. Jesus Christ is setting you free and redirect your life. He will invite you to come to one enemy. You can be set free from the bounds of sin. You don't have to wake up in a holy cell. You don't have to worry about the police behind you. You don't have to worry about those things because you can be set free and given a new life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Would you accept Jesus Christ today? What is he going to do with Jesus Christ? Is he going to become him or reject him? Jesus Christ has become real. You can boldly come before the throne of grace, and Jesus Christ will give you that grace. His grace is sufficient for you. His mercy is yours forever. Jesus Christ wants to help you. He wants to save you. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. He wants to save you. He can give you your manhood back. He can make you a man again. You can be what he created you to be. You don't have to be a slave. You don't have to be pimped for your soul.
I'm the walking lab. I'm Alzheimer's Jews. Jewish people have Alzheimer's described all gone.
Huh.
I'm their rabbi. I'm going to go to the next one. Knock, knock.